From the depths of the Atlantic Ocean rises a mysterious fort. Home to a horde of fearsome beasts and grisly guardians.
Inside this ancient stone stronghold, a priceless treasure awaits the bravest of bounty hunters.
This formidable place is the legendary Fort Boyard.
Six fearless teams have set out on the ultimate challenge to beat the fort and carry off its treasure.
In a daring quest to win keys that will unlock the gold from the treasure chamber, they'll face their fears and test their courage to the limit.
The two teams who collect the most coins throughout the series will battle it out in the grand final to be crowned ultimate conquerors of the fort.
Who has the skill, the strength, the bravery to take home the trophy?
Will it be one of the two teams on today's Fort Boyard Ultimate Challenge?
Welcome to Fort Boyard Ultimate Challenge. Our two teams have landed and they are ready to face their fears and tackle any challenges this mighty fort might throw at them.
These two pieces of metal are what it's all about, coins and keys. Five of these keys will get you the maximum amount of time in the treasure chamber to grab these shiny gold coins. Now, these are the fort's precious treasure.
Win a challenge and they will win a key. But who will walk away with the most gold? Who knows? It's time to meet the team.
Teams, where are you?
The crocodiles are strong, agile predators.
The crocodiles will snap up the keys in the fort.
The crocs rock.
There's no point in the other team showing up. The crocodiles are going to win this.
You best not get too near, because the tarantulas are the ones to fear.
Tarantulas are the best, and we're going to rock this.
The tarantulas are going to wrap the other teams up in our web and eat them for breakfast.
Who's going to win?
Easy, the tarantulas.
The crocs!
Katie, your team captain for the Crocs. Who's your most competitive team member?
Definitely Alex.
Who's the strongest?
Alex.
All about Alex then, by the sounds of things. Let's hear that chant one more time.
Who rock?
The Crocs rock!
Who rock?
The Crocs rock!
Feel the fear, tarantulas.
Tarantulas, welcome.
We have no fear.
Welcome indeed. This is what I like to hear. You look, it's the Alex show over there. I'm hoping this is more of a team effort. What's going on?
We each have our individual talents, so I'm a swimmer. You're both very strong. You've got the brains.
Nice.
So, all together.
This is what I like to hear, Abby. Look, yes. I'm hoping you guys win today because you are very modest anyway. So let's hope that the tarantulas walk away with this key, yeah?
Yeah.
Fingers crossed.
Let's hope the crocs walk away with this key. Healthy competition.
Yeah,
you've met
like
the teams. It's time to find out what the first challenge is.
Teams, first challenge and first opportunity to win a key. So, Charlie, you're doing this for the tarantulas, and Amelia, you're doing this for the crocodiles. This is what you have to do. You're 30 feet above the treasure chamber, above some very hungry tigers. You need to edge your way across the cable using those wooden blocks. Grab the tool, make your way back, undo the wallet, and shout out the code to your teammates. The first team to grab the key shall win this challenge. We'll start with you, Amelia. Looking a bit nervous there. What's going through your mind?
I'm going to die. You're probably not going to die.
You're not going to die. I'm sure of this. We're going to make sure you're very safe. Does it worry you that you're so high up?
Oh, don't say that. It's even worse.
All right, Charlie, how are you feeling, bro?
Feeling good.
Yeah? All right, let's begin. Your challenge starts now.
Now, they are, of course, both harnessed, so they're not going to fall.
That'll be fine, that'll be fine.
Well, they could fall off.
Well, Charlie's got off to a great start.
They're really not going to be eaten by the tigers.
No. I don't know. Anything can happen, I always say this. All right, Charlie's grabbed the tool. Turns around. He needs to make sure he doesn't drop that tool. He needs to make sure he doesn't drop that tool.
It is not too far behind, but come on.
Amelia's grabbed the tool already. There we go.
Come on, pull it!
Charlie's got to make sure he doesn't drop that tool.
Keep going.
Can I speak?
Oh my God.
All right, get ready by the key box.
Come on, Amelia.
Work to do.
Come on, you
do the wallet.
Catch up.
He still needs to undo the wallet.
Come on, Amelia, you can catch up.
7842. 7842. 7842. There we go.
Stop. Stop. The key goes to the tarantula. Yeah. Let's take a look at the replay.
I knew that Amelia was scared of heights and I wasn't, so I thought, she's not going to go as quick as I am.
The wire was jiggling everywhere. My feet were, like, dangling along the end. And he got there and back by the time I've only got to the tool.
It looks really easy, but when you get up there, it is so stiff and you have to use your stomach muscles and your legs so much, and it's just so hard.
OK, let's take a look at the scores so far. The tarantulas have one key and the crocs have no keys. Well done, teams. All right, tarantulas, there is another opportunity right now to win another key and just stretch that lead even further. How are you feeling? Ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's do this. Come on. Yes, tarantulas. Flying start. Time for your next challenge. Who's doing this? Harry, my man, what are your description skills like?
They're all right. I reckon I can get my message through.
All right, good communication is what I like. This is what you have to do. So, outside here is a special grid with numbers. What you've got to do is go inside the cell and put your hand in some boxes. You basically got to describe the pattern that you feel in those boxes and shout it out to your teammates who will match it to the number on the grid. For the code, you need 3 digits. You need to grab those balls, put them in the machine, close it, and hopefully this key will be revealed in time. But it ain't that easy, because in those boxes, there's some rather creepy crawlies and creatures in there. Are you squeamish?
Not really.
Yeah, okay, well, you're the tarantula, so you know. You're in your zone right now. Any pressure from going into there?
No, I'm confident. We've won a key, so I reckon we can get another one.
All right, let's go. Get in there, mate.
Come on, Harry.
Your time starts now. Come on, mate. Give it a good go. Hands in that. Hands in and just.
It's just cockroaches straight in there.
Straight in. All right, throw out windows.
What can you feel, bro? It should be at the bottom. Should be at the bottom of the.
Oh, wait, found it.
Come on. Make sure you feel both sides.
Keep crawling over it.
Just brush them out the way, mate.
I think.
Just brush them all out the way. Clear it up for yourself. There you go. What can you feel?
It's really hard to tell.
It's only cockroaches, bro.
Top left, middle left, bottom left.
There's none like that. There's none with a 3 and a line down the left-hand side.
Wait. Describe it again, mate, and hurry up.
All right,
Is there another one?
Top left, middle right, middle left, and then bottom left.
Bottom right. Right, so was that top left, top right, middle left, bottom right?
Yeah.
Six, I reckon.
Okay, move on.
Next one.
What you got?
Oh, that's snakes.
Come on, mate.
Move out of the way.
Get out of the way. Come on, Harry.
Oh, it's moving.
You can do it, mate. What you got?
I've got top right, top left, middle left, and bottom right.
Six. We've just done that. We've done six. Last bucket. Go.
Tony frogs, mate.
Wait, hang on.
Hurry up.
So top right, middle left. Bottom right.
Come on, Harry. You've got to get out.
Any.
Have a guess. Give it a go. What have you got? You lost the key. Come on out, bro. Oh, lucky.
Good job.
Mate, you took so long. What was going on?
It was hard. The cockroaches kept getting in the way. I kept thinking they were the little
buns. All right, well, let's take a look at the highlights.
When I put my hand into the cockroaches, after a while, sort of, the little sharp bits of their shell sort of kept, like, pricking at my hand, so I kept pulling out. Sort of with the snakes as well.
I think I moved one a bit too quickly and I felt it sort of wrap around my hand, so that's when I pulled out. And then sort of the frogs were just a bit easier, really. They just felt really gooey.
I think you were just getting a bit confused because your first and second one were exactly the same one. Yeah. The third one was just a stab in the dark. But anyway, let's take a look at the scores. One key to the tarantulas and no keys to the crocodiles. Okay. Still ahead, still ahead. Let's see how Laura's doing with those crocs.
Now, crocodiles, I've got some good news. They unsuccessfully completed their challenge. So, if you guys can win this key, you can make it one all. Are you ready for this?
Yes!
So, here's what you have to do. In front of you, you see a beam. You've got to walk across that beam and get the code, which is at the far end. Shout it out to your teammates all before time runs out. Now, whilst you're walking across the beam, expect to get a little wet because water will be shooting up at random. It's going to take a lot of balance. Keep your eye focused on that code. Now, Katie, you're going to be going first. If you fall in, you'll be out of the game. But, Alex, it means you can step up to the challenge. So, two chances to get this key. We can do it, team?
Yes!
Right, off we go then. Katie, if you'd like to take your place.
Come on, Katie, just tee your time.
Your challenge starts now!
Go on, Katie, come on!
Slow and steady.
Yeah, just take it steady.
It's all about timing this. Right. Oh, could the water be shooting up already? Whoa! Well done! Well done!
Now, come on, just keep
she falls
going.
Off,
otherwise
she will be out, but they will have another... Stepping up to the challenge, the beam is wobbling all over the place here. Katie, just wait there. The team will come and get you. Be careful, Alex. This is your last chance.
See your turn, Alex. Come on. Slow and
these guys come on up, let's take a look back at that action.
The water sprays were definitely much stronger than I had thought.
Yeah, I got halfway over and then the water just got me from behind and it really put me off because I didn't see it coming. Yeah, I was there for a good 5 seconds trying to maintain balance and I thought I almost had it. Yeah, and then just that last gust of wind that just took me off.
Well, there's plenty more chances for you to win plenty more keys later, but let's have a look at how that affects the scoreboard. One key to the tarantulas and still no keys to the crocodiles. Time now for us to take a quick break, but don't go anywhere because there's lots more to come on Fort Boyard Ultimate Challenge.
Magicky puppies are extra cute bundles of fun who love to cuddle and are ready to play. Lady is super soft, Blue changes colour and Chloe glows in the dark. 12 puppies to collect and love. Magicky Puppies, out now.
Magicky Puppies!
Welcome back to Fort Boyard Ultimate Challenge. The tarantulas are taking on the crocodiles to see who can win as many keys as they can from the fort. It's a very close contest at the moment because the tarantulas have one key and the crocodiles have no keys. But the next challenge is for both our teams. Who's going to walk away with that valuable key? Let's find out. Okay, two teams. One key stands between you at the moment. This is a challenge that both you teams need to win. So, Charlie, you're doing it for the tarantulas, and Jack, you'll be doing it for the crocodiles. This is what you have to do. You're going to go into that cell, and it's quite a special cell because it's the only one that the longer you stay in, the smaller it becomes. You need to go above you. There's an overhead grid with some tools. You need to find the right tools to open the caged box, which will have the code, which you need to shout out to your teammates in order to grab the key. But it ain't so simple. As I said, the room gets smaller and smaller. As you're in there, the ceiling is lowered and you'll be joined by what I like to call a rather big, gruesome snake.
Come on, Andy, it's not that big.
It is massive. Like, you know it's massive.
Like, yeah, okay, it's quite big.
God, don't lie. It is massive. Are you two ready?
Yeah.
Okay, make your way in.
Come on, Charlie.
Watch out for that 4-metre snake.
You know what? That is quite big.
Don't listen to him, Charlie.
Your challenge starts now.
Come on, Charlie!
This challenge is not for the faint-hearted. Jack's keeping a healthy distance from that massive snake.
So, the crocodiles are going for the white tools and the tarantulas are going for the black tools.
And they've got to find the correct tools to undo the box. Some of those tools won't fit, so they've got to keep going until they find the right ones. But it looks like the tarantulas have found one already.
Charlie's got off to a good start. He's already opened the first lock. OK, you need to look for the second tool.
That ceiling is getting lower and lower.
Has he just found the right two tools? OK, stand by your box. Let's listen out for Charlie, see if he gets it.
Come on, Charlie.
1726. Have they got it? 1726. Stop! Challenge over! The key goes to the tarantulas! Strong!
I wasn't worried much about that snake because it was quite big and it wasn't moving much. But the roof coming down on top was a bit scary because of how fast it was coming down.
I looked at the bolts first and I picked the two I knew were gonna fit. So it was really obvious.
What does it feel like when the ceiling's coming down?
You have to get lower and lower quite quickly.
I didn't notice it.
He didn't even notice, did he?
I wouldn't notice it if I was in there.
That massive snake. Anyway, let's take a look at the scores. The two keys to the tarantulas and no keys to the crocs. Unlucky. Yay! Tarantulas, we are gathering steam. Let's see if we can find ourselves another key. Come with me, let's go. This is proving to be a good competition for you. Let's make this one yet another key. Who's doing it?
That's me.
Lauren, I like this. Now, what you've got to do is to grab the key, which is on a giant spring. You need to pull it all the way up the spring to take it off. But there are two heavy bags you need to get off first, and the spring itself is spinning, so that gives it an extra bit of difficulty. How are you feeling about this?
I'm feeling confident, feeling good, yep. Hopefully I won't get too dizzy, though.
Yeah, that's what I like. Very positive. Let's hope you spring into action and get us this key, yeah?
Yep.
All right, make your way in.
Come on, Lauren.
Because your challenge starts now.
As quick as possible, straight in there. That's it, you're doing really, really well.
All right, as quick as possible.
Keep going. You're doing really, really well.
There's a little stopper there that makes it really difficult for you to pull all the bags
keep
and the key
moving,
up.
Keep
going, Lauren, you've got to keep going. Don't forget you're being timed. So good to get this key.
We're going to a massive lead to get this key.
Come on, Lauren.
Lauren tells me she's a dancer, so she should be quite agile. She could be, should be quite flexible for something like this. There we go. Come on, Lauren.
Doing
very well indeed. Very well.
Come on, Lauren.
This is quite an interesting tactic. She's managed to take the stopper with her along the way.
Come on, Lauren.
Come on, Lauren. Keep going. Almost there. This is a fantastic tactic. Come on, Lauren. OK, there's a stopper. Now grab the bag and grab the key. What a tactic. So basically, the stopper we put in place, she's already removed, which is making it easier for her to grab the bag and also grab the key as well and navigate her way to the top of the spring. Lauren, you need to get a move on, though. Time is running out. Come on, Lauren, keep going. We really want you to get this key. Time is running out. Can she do it in time? Can Lauren get the key and make it three keys for the tarantulas? Almost there. Lauren, time is running out. You're not far. She got it. Oh, my heart is beating. Get out, she's got the key, come on. Yes, yes, yes. absolutely fantastic. Let's take a look at that replay.
So what I was trying to do was climb actually on the spring so that when I was getting nearer the top where I couldn't quite reach to drag off the obstacles, it was just making my life quite a bit easier. It was actually really difficult. I'm really out of breath now. But yeah. And you get so dizzy walking round and round, but I've got the key.
What 18? Well, let's take a look at the scores. It's three keys to the tarantulas and no keys to the crocodile tarantulas. OK, well, let's see if the crocodiles can actually get a key this time with Laura.
Crocodiles, the tarantulas just got a third key. Does that just make you want this even more, Katie?
Yeah, definitely.
Right, here's what you have to do. In this cell, you're going to sit in a chair. That chair is going to spin pretty quickly. You've got to make your way across the wobbly bridge, collect the pearls that are coming out of the machine in front of you, make your way back over, fill the tube with the pearls you've just collected to raise the level of the key. Now, team, we really, really need this key. Yes. Remember, every key you get just gives you valuable time in the treasure chamber to collect the fort's precious gold. You can do this, Katie. You're going to need this.
Thank you.
Take your place in the cell, sit in the chair. Okay, and your challenge will begin when I say. Challenge starts now!
Oh, my gosh!
Katie.
Let's go, Katie.
Oh, this is dizzy. Let's go, let's go.
Get your balance.
Pretty disorientated. Wow. She ran across there pretty quickly. A lot of pearls collected.
Back, 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 back across. The chair really quickly.
Fill up.
All about speed.
Yeah, be careful
Cylinder
when you're
there,
pouring,
Katie.
There you go.
Come go, on, go,
back go, in the chair. Go. Get ready to go for another spin. Got her eyes closed.
Okay,
hold on tight, Katie.
Go, go, go.
Quick, quick,
quick. Come on, Katie! Really? Taking a fall. Doesn't look like she collected many pearls there.
Come on, Katie, be careful.
Be quick when you go in.
Come on, Katie, you're not collecting many pearls. You're going to need to collect a lot more before the level of that key raises.
Get off the chair quicker. Don't sit on the chair for too long afterwards.
Go, 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 go.
Whoop!
That's better. I'll keep doing
that. That looked a lot better.
Come on.
Katie!
Keep going.
Be careful when you're pouring them.
Come on, you don't have much time left. Come on, keep
that
going.
That
was much better.
Yes, go, like that.
Two more like that, two more.
Will she need to go twice? Maybe just once?
Yeah, lots on this one,
Katie. Come on, Katie, sprint down that bridge.
Make this trip a good one, Katie. Still looks like she managed to get a few pearls there. Come on back over and fill that machine. Is this going to be enough? Time is ticking.
Not much time at all.
Time's running out. See if you can grab it.
Get it, get it.
Come on, get it. Get it, get it. Get it, get it. Out. And you can. Crazy. Steady now. Whilst you get your balance back, let's take a look at the action replay.
As soon as I got on the chair, it felt really, really dizzy. After the third turn, I think I just felt really sick, and I made such a face that is probably going to be shown, which doesn't look too good.
Katie, how are you feeling?
Oh, I feel so good. I got the key, but I feel really sick now.
Oh, it's not easy, is it?
No.
But the important thing is you did it all just in the nick of time, and you got yourself the key! Let's take a look at the scores. It's three keys to the tarantulas and now one key to the crocodiles. Yes, give me a five. Woo-hoo! Ready to try and win another key?
Yes.
Let's join Andy for our next duel. Follow me, come on. Woo! This next challenge is for both of our teams. Jack and Abby are up here with me, 60 feet above the ocean. They're going to ride the zip wire with a padlock in their hand down to meet their teammates who are waiting in kayaks. They're going to pass them the padlock key. Their teammates will paddle over to the buoy, reveal the code and shout it out to their teammates who are waiting at the key box with Andy on the steps below. Have you ever ridden a zip wire before, Jack?
Definitely not this height, but...
Definitely not this height and definitely not over the ocean. Yep. Abby, how are you feeling about this challenge?
I have to say I'm looking forward to the zip wire ride down. I'm really looking forward. I really want to win this key, so I have a massive lead ahead.
Yeah, you will have a massive lead ahead. Jack, you really need this key. Got anything you want to say to Abby?
Oh, look, the
my shadow down there, or just when I'm beating you?
Oh, oh. I like it. Right, well, if you'd like to take your position, please. At the platform. No arguing, guys. Take your place at the edge of the platform. Your challenge starts now.
Go!
Woo! Oh, my
God.
Here they go.
Who's going to get it first? Who's going to get off that zip line first? And they're off. Who's going to get it first?
Go!
These guys barging each other. They're barging each other. This is incredible. They've both got the keys. This is a race for the boy. Whoever can kayak better and much more speed in at this point is going to grab that cone. They're almost neck to neck, really. It is incredible.
Come on, Harry!
Come on, who's going to get this? Who's going to get this?
Oh, who's in the lead? What's going on?
Now he's getting juicy. Got the cross of her head.
Come on! So close!
Harry's coming back. Who's going to get to the code first? This is a brilliant contest. This is a brilliant contest. This is a brilliant contest.
Who wants
this? Who wants this? Who's going to get the code first?
3-play.
As soon as we let go of the roof and we got going on the zip wire, it was so fun, it felt like we were flying.
The water was really choppy, so it made it harder to swim, but luckily I beat Abby to the kayaks.
The current was quite strong and it was quite choppy as well, so we were going up and down, sort of trying to fight the wave.
I managed to get to the code first to unlock the padlock, and I shouted out to my team, but they couldn't hear me the first few times because it was really noisy, so I had to keep yelling it.
Well done. Well, you've managed to get yourself a second key. Shall we have a look at how that affects the scoreboard? It's 3 to the tarantulas and 2 to the crocodiles. We're there. Woo! Time for us to take a quick break now, but don't go anywhere because there's lots more to come on Fort Boyard's Ultimate Challenge.
Welcome back to Fort Boyard Ultimate Challenge. The Crocs are taking on the Tarantulas in a close contest today. So far, the scores are 3 keys to the Tarantulas and 2 keys to the Crocs. I predict a big battle coming on, but who will be victorious? Well, let's find out. Tarantulas, this challenge is for you. We need to grab this key because they're coming back. You ready, Lauren?
I am indeed, yeah.
All right, let's do this. So, in that room is a giant coffee grinder. You need to use this scoop to scoop up some coffee and put it in the coffee grinder. When you've put enough coffee in the grinder, a green light will be lit. You need to press the button to make the coffee, which will release the key. But ain't gonna be that easy because you're gonna be running on a spinning platform. Okay. Just to make it that bit more difficult. How are you feeling?
Good. I'm feeling confident. Yeah, hopefully I don't fall over too much.
All right, mate. Get in there. Have faith. I'll just, before you go in, mine's a strong and black.
Right.
Get in. Your challenge starts now.
Come on, Lauren.
I have faith. Yeah, pack it full. Go. Run on that spinning platform and pour the coffee in.
That's it.
Pour the coffee in. There you go, dude. OK, there's enough there. Keep going, Lauren.
Keep going, Lauren.
Fast as you can. Really wanted to get this. I think they lost a bit of confidence doing the kayaking. This could be it for them. Come on, Lauren. She's doing brilliant. She's doing brilliant, you guys. Really, absolutely brilliant.
Come on, Lauren.
There we go. She's found her groove. She's found her groove.
Come on, Lauren.
There you go, Lauren. Keep going. She is a machine. She's found her pace. Oh, Lauren, beautiful, beautiful. Almost there. Almost there. Keep going, Lauren. Well, let's give her some encouragement. Come on. Come on. It's getting faster and faster, that thing. That platform's getting faster and faster. Lauren, press the button. Keep your hand on it. Keep coming, keep going! Keep going, this is brilliant. Where's the key? The key, put your hand in, the key's in the cupboard. Grab the key! Grab the key! Come out, come out, come out! Yes, it's me! Yes, yes! Well done! Oh my goodness, it took an eternity for that key to come out.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at the replay.
I think towards the end, the key was taking such a long time to come up that I didn't actually realise I could grab it a lot sooner. And so that was something that I probably could have done a bit quicker, but I got the key in the end, so it was OK.
Mmm, smells of a rich dark roast. I love it.
So do I.
How was it in there, man?
It was really tricky. The wheel got faster. Mm-hmm. So I was carrying on, so it's really tiring.
And guess what? You got the key. Yeah. Well done. Woo! Let's take a look at the scores. We've got four keys to the tarantulas and two keys to the crocodile. Tarantulas, yes! That's what we're talking about. OK, let's see if the crocodiles can up their game with Laura.
This next challenge is a brand new challenge of this series and it's not for the faint-hearted. Waiting in the treasure chamber below in a specially designed safari buggy is Amelia. It's her job to pedal the buggy over to the chute just here. Her teammates will pour water down the chute and into the back of the buggy's tank. Amelia must then make her way over to the other side of the treasure chamber. Using the pump in the buggy, she must empty the tank and fill up the water tube to reveal the code and shout it out to her teammates who are waiting up here. The Tigers will be joining you shortly, Amelia. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Your challenge starts now. Amelia. She's already curbed the alloys. Okay, now she needs to make sure she gets directly under the chute.
Come back a bit.
No, come back.
Well done, Amelia. Yeah. The Tigers have been released.
Right,
forward
a bit.
No back.
Now, the back of the jeep needs to be directly under the chute.
It's nowhere near at all.
Right hand still.
Right, no back. You've got
try pouring some water down.
Right.
Don't get her wet, though.
No. Right down!
Uh-oh. Yeah, stop.
Yeah, right there, don't move.
OK.
That looks OK.
Come on, go.
Can you put any more in there?
OK, oh,
go.
Wow. Are leaving her alone at the moment.
Yeah, thanks.
Don't seem too interested.
Oh, hi, Fargo.
Ah.
Go.
Amelia's watching over her left shoulder there.
Go.
Come on, Amelia.
Hurry. See if you can get a tiny bit closer.
That's it. Now make sure that water goes in the tube and not on the floor.
There you go.
That's better. There you go.
Keep pumping.
Keep going. OK, the Tiger's just decided to take a little lie down behind you there, Amelia. So when you reverse, just be careful.
There you go.
OK. This is looking good. Remember, time is ticking.
Hurry.
Out of water. There's a Tiger in the way. Good work, Amelia.
Stop turning it right.
OK, well...
You're running out of time, Amelia.
Come back straight.
Now, teammates, you need to make sure that water goes into the tank and not onto the floor.
Just chuck it on.
This is
An interesting approach.
Is there going to be enough water in the tank there?
Not long. And this key is going to burn out. She really needs to move. Come on. Yes, and we're away. Come on, Amelia. It's going to burn out. It's gone. Time is up. Crocs, unfortunately, you have lost the key. Well, let's take a look back at some of that exciting action.
I was about a centimetre away from a real live tiger.
It was really funny to watch because she screamed every time water was chucked on her, which then upset the tigers.
So I didn't realise how big they would be, how strong they would be, how loud they would be.
Amelia?
Yeah?
Good work, but unfortunately you did run out of time. It looks like the tiger's enjoying that tyre just there. Let's have a look at how that affects the scoreboard. It's still 4 keys to the tarantulas and 2 keys to the crocodiles. Never mind, team. Come on. Let's give it up for Amelia. We're going to get Amelia out of the buggy and then we're going to join Andy for the final duel. Your last chance to win a key. Come on, guys. Follow me. Woo-hoo! Teams. This is your last chance to win a key. Who wants it?
Tarantulas!
Well, you both want it. Mm. But, Crocs, you need this key. One at a time, you're going to step forward and place a shape in this glass box. The person that puts a shape in that sticks out from the top of the box will lose the challenge for their team. I'm going to be checking with this here tool. I feel like a teacher.
I was going to say that.
So,
you.
Step forward. Lauren, choose a piece. Once you have picked that piece, you are committed to it. You can't change. Place that piece in the glass box. Okay. Crocs, Katie, step forward.
It's a very big shape right now. Part of their
tactics. Well done, Katie. Charlie, pick a shape.
Another square.
OK, we're safe. Crocs, who's stepping forward? Jack, pick a shape. Interesting. Up next for the tarantulas, Abby, team captain. Okay, we're in yet again, another big shape. So Amelia stepping forward for the crocodiles.
Yeah, I knew you. Yeah, well done.
Square.
What do you do here?
Harry? This is where it gets interesting.
Less and less space.
Game over. Yes, I can confirm it is out of the box, so that means the final challenge is won by the crocodiles!
I knew what to do, but I think I must have let go of it funny because it went off at an angle and it sort of came over the top. So I was just disappointed for the team and I was really sorry.
Let's take a look at the scores. The crocodiles have 3 keys and the tarantulas have 4 keys. Close contest.
Well done, teams. There's no more keys to be won, but there's one more place to go. Where are we headed?
The treasure chamber.
To unlock the gate and receive the full 3 minutes in the treasure chamber, each team must have 5 keys.
For each key less than 5, there's a 10-second time penalty. Each key over 5 earns a bonus of 150 gold coins.
Once the gate is unlocked, the time begins and each team will be shown a map of the treasure chamber floor with 4 crests marked on it.
They must memorise the 4 crest positions on the map and then place them on the corresponding squares on the chamber floor, all under the watchful eyes of the 4 tigers.
Each player then places a hand on the scanner and, if they're correct, the key to the treasure chest will be released and the team can start collecting the gold.
If they are wrong, they must reposition their crest until they get it right. The team with the most coins wins.
Teams, welcome. You've made it here. The treasure chamber! Yeah. Now,
Now, remember, you've got to make this count. Grab as many gold coins as you possibly can. The total number of coins you get will be added to your overall tournament leaderboard score.
So, you needed 5 keys to earn the maximum amount of time in the treasure chamber. Start with you, Tarantulas. You got 4 keys, which is still pretty good. Round of applause for yourselves. But it does mean you do have a 10-second time penalty, so I'll put this key in the lock for you.
Crocs, you got 3 keys. You brought yourself back into the game. Well done. But with 2 keys down, you're going to get a 20-second time penalty. So, for you, Tarantulas, when the gate starts to open, your map will be revealed. Your map will be revealed, Crocs, when your time penalty is up. Is everyone ready for this?
Yes!
I think they're ready, Andy.
I predict a good battle. Your challenge starts now.
Tarantulas are studying their map. It's all about the map reading at this point, as we know too well on Fort Boyard.
Croc's map has been revealed too. Can they catch up?
Okay. Already in. Croc's as well in. Interesting. Straight in there! Tarantulas, first time! Brilliant stuff! There we go! Lift the load, let's go!
Yes, they're right too! Come on, Croc! Oh, steady there, Alex!
What great adversaries. Two great adversaries going head to head. Very strong teams indeed.
They are great teams, and they usually have pretty good pace.
It's going to be close. It's going to be very close.
Keep going! Go, teams, remember, the total number of coins will be added to your overall tournament leaderboard score. This is what it's all about. You know, I've kind of felt for the Crocs. They've been so close with a couple of challenges. There's Tigers watching in the background.
Scooping all that gold. In the true spirit of the tournament, both teams are going very strong.
That's it, time is up. Go now! Come on, teams!
Who's it takes?
I think it's going to be an incredibly close treasure chamber. Let's take a look at that action.
In the treasure team, we got the map right first time, and I'm really proud of our team.
Our main focus was just ignore everyone else and focus on what our team could do.
When the light goes green, there's a massive sigh of relief because you know you can just start collecting coins as quick as you can, and it's just amazing.
OK, the moment we've all been waiting for. After that treasure chamber, we want to know who has taken the most gold.
Let's find out, then. Let's weigh the Crocs coins first. Katie, were you happy with your team's overall performance there in the treasure chamber?
I was really happy with our take, even though we got a time penalty. I'm happy with it.
Here we go. Well done.
Now, let's see just how many you took.
Done indeed. Okay, Tarantulas. You got 4 keys. Map reading skills were on point as usual. Abby, do you think you've done enough just to beat these guys?
And there's quite a big haul there. I think we've definitely tried our best, and there's definitely a lot of coins in there.
That looks like a massive take. Well, stand back. Let's find out just how many coins you have all managed to grab. Let's take a look at your total.
Wow.
1,480.
That is big.
Which means today's winners are the Tarantulas! Yay! Well done, the Crocs, but Who knows whether that has, you know, made you our finalists? We'll have to find out in just a second, because before we find out who our overall finalists are, let's welcome back all our teams. So first off, let's hear it for the Rhinos! Come on, Rhinos!
Then let's hear it for the Eagles! Yes.
The Tigers!
And last but not least, it's the Cobras! Teams, welcome back to the fort.
Right. This is it. It's now time to announce the two teams that will be going to the grand final. The first team with an overall score of 3,900 Boyard gold coins is the Rhinos!
Congratulations, Rhinos. Very well done. But the team who are going head to head against the Rhinos, and who do have the biggest score of the series, it's 4,220, is the Tarantulas!
Wow!
Wow!
OK, so it was really close at the top there, but let's just have a look at the overall tournament leaderboard to confirm our finalists.
And there we have it, the final scores. After weeks of intense competition, it's the Rhinos and the Tarantulas who will face off in the grand final.
I've got to say a massive thank you to all our teams that have taken part, but I do think we are going to have an epic final on our hands.
Epic, the perfect word for it. Make sure you join us next time for the grand final of Fort Boyard Ultimate Challenge.
We'll see you
next time.
Bye-bye.
I'm really proud of my team for getting to the final. I couldn't have asked for a better team.
There is never a challenge too big for the Rhinos.
I'm so excited right now. We got through to the finals and we weren't expecting that.
Who's going to win? Quite clearly us, the Rhinos.
As team captain, I'm looking forward to leading the Tarantulas into victory.
The pressure is definitely mounting seeing as we're in the final.
There's a reason people are afraid of Tarantulas.
We were born to win this.